Felipe Drugovic, both F2 multiple race winner and my namesake, is set to be a title contender for the 2021 FIA Formula 2 season. But could he be Brazil's next superstar? Let's find out. Let's start from the basics, shall we? Felipe Drugovic Roncato was born the 23rd of May, 2000, making him 20 years old at the time of recording, in Maringá, Brazil. Drugovic always had an interest in racing, and at the age of 9, started karting in the South Brazilian Karting Championship, in which he had ended up finishing second in 2010 and first in 2011 and 2012. In 2016, after some pretty still years, Drugovic moved to Europe to compete in the ADAC Formula 4 Championship with Neuhauser Racing. He did not have a very good first year there and finished 12th in the championship, as well as getting beaten by drivers such as Mick Schumacher and Yuri Vips. Simultaneously, he also competed in the MRF Challenge Formula 2000, in which he took his first race car victory. In 2017, Drugovic re-entered the ADAC Formula 4 Championship, but this time with Van Amersfoort Racing, or VAR. The Brazilian enjoyed a much successful campaign, achieving 7 wins, 3 poles, 9 podiums and 6 fastest laps, and finishing P3 in the championship, but ultimately still got beaten by future F2 rivals such as Marcus Armstrong and yet again, Yuri Vips. 2018 was the Brazilian's best year, winning 3 championships in the forms of the MRF Challenge Formula 2000, Euro Formula Open Championship and Spanish Formula 3, and managed to beat drivers like Bent Viscount and Guilherme Samaya. In 2019, Drugovic went through probably the worst season of his racing career in the FIA Formula 3 Championship. Driving for Carlin this time, the Brazilian finished 16th in the driver's standing. Crucially, however, ahead of his teammates Teperi Natori and Logan Sargeant, which shows that the Carlin was average at best. It was looking like Drugovic would be without a seat for 2020, but in a surprising move, MP Motorsport signed Drugovic to compete in the FIA Formula 2 Championship for 2020. You might question why MP Motorsport would bring in a guy who had just finished in 16th the previous year. Well, the response was that he had seen his talent in the lower categories and knew what he was capable of. But also, we cannot forget that the man he replaced was the much talented and popular sensation, Mahavir Raghunathan. This was the year Drugovic had to prove himself, and he did just that. The Brazilian managed 3 wins, including 2 feature races in Austria and Barcelona, and 1 sprint race in Bahrain. All things considered, Drugovic did very well, seeing as MP's 2020 car was pretty average, and yet again beating both of his teammates, this time Giuliano Alesi and Nobuhiro Matsushita. For the 2021 season, Drugovic has remained in the FIA Formula 2 series, but this time, he'll be driving for both the drivers and constructor runners-up, UNI Virtuosi, alongside race winner, Guan Yu Zhou. At the time of making this video, the opening Bahrain races have already happened, and Drugovic managed to qualify a best P3, but fell short in the races with a best finish of P9, which can be pointed to bad strategies, whilst his teammate is now a 2-time race winner. Nevertheless, we are only at the beginning of the season, and Drugovic still has 21 races to show his talents. But overall, let's get back to the main question of the video. And could Felipe Drugovic be Brazil's next superstar? Well, in my opinion, I believe he can be as long as he remains consistent and has a good car behind him. Throughout his career, Drugovic has shown very good results with mediocre cars. And if he can keep producing those results, whilst now having a race-winning car behind him, I truly believe he can become Brazil's next superstar. But what do you think? Can Felipe Drugovic become Brazil's next future superstar? Or will he end up not even reaching the top level of motorsport? If you enjoyed this video, I'd love some feedback in the comments, and I hope you have a very nice day.